Morning students, we are going to deal with the ninth chapter of history of for class 8, foundation of the British rule in India. We have to continue with the chapter. We have already completed about the European trades in India, the Portuguese settlement, the Dutch East India Company, the English East India Company, and students, this the French East India Company, Anglo-French rivalry, and the first Carnatic War, the second Carnatic War, and the third Carnatic War. These are not there in your syllabus. Please cut it out. We have to continue with the rise of British power in Bengal. Bengal was the first kingdom to be occupied by the British in India. It was the most fertile and the richest of India's provinces. The provinces was also well known for its textile, silk, and the saltpeter. The East India Company carried a profitable trade with these provinces. The immemorial source of Bengal came in handy for the financing the British expansion. Means was the Bengal was occupied by the British, and it was the main source of finance for the British expansion. In 1717 CE, the company had secured from the Mughal Emperor Fakhruddin a Farman, guaranteeing it the right to carry on trade in Bengal without paying any duty to the government. So the Farman was there by the Fakhruddin to the company that for the trade in Bengal, they haven't to pay any the type of duty. The employees of the company, though permitted to carry a private trade, would have to pay tax like an Indian merchant. And the employees of the company, if they are having the private trade, they were permitted to have the trade, but they have to pay the taxes. Only the East India Company was there to have the farman in which they haven't to pay the tax in Bengal. Okay, now yeah, but the servant of company misused the farman to evade taxes on the private trade. They also began to sell their passes to the friendly Indian traders. They not only use that farman for their personal trade, plus they also use that farman to sell these passes to the friendly Indian traders. The farman was a perpetual, means what, never ending source of conflict between the company and the Nawab of Bengal. The Nawab lost revenue from trade. More importantly, he protested against the misuse of the dastak or permit by the company servant who carried on private trades. Now, the Battle of Plassey. In 1756, Sir Richard Dulla succeeded his grandson, Aliwardi Khan, as a Nabab of Bengal. Now, the new Nabab was there, Sarajuddin. Okay, the English victory in the Carnatic had already made Sarajuddin apprehensive of growing power of the East India Company. He wanted to curb this power. So Sarajuddin was knowing the power of the company, and he wanted to curb, to remove the power, to less down the power of the company. Meanwhile, the English started fortifying Kolkata without obtaining permission from the Nawab. Okay, Calcutta, without the permission of the Nawab. And who was the Nawab that time? Sarajuddin. Okay, this amounted to ignoring the sovereign power, supreme power. The infuriated Nawab marched to Calcutta and occupied Fort William in June 1756. Most of the soldiers fled to Fulta. After conquering Calcutta, Sarajuddin marched back to Murshidabad. His success, however, was short-lived. Robert Clive arrived with a strong army force and reconquered Calcutta at the beginning of 1757 CE. He compelled the Nawab to concede all the demands of English, including the right of fortifying Calcutta. The English, however, was not satisfied. They wanted to install a puppet Nawab on the throne of Bengal. Clive entered into a conspiracy with the Mir Zafar. Now, who was the Mir Zafar? Mir Zafar was the commander of Nawab, Sarajuddin, and other to overthrow the Sarajuddin. Mir Zafar would be made the Nawab of Bengal after Bengal in return of the huge sum of money as a reward of the company. And behalf of that, if the Mirzafar is going to help the company, Mirzafar would meet the Nawab of Bengal and was being paid a huge money as a reward. The British were now presented the Nawab with the impossible set of demand. Both sides realized that war was inevitable. The two armies met at the field of Palasi, just over 20 miles south of Murshidabad, on 23rd June 1757. Battle of Palasi was a battle only in the name. The major part of the Nawab army under the Mirzafar took no part in fighting. The Nawab was forced to flee, but he was captured and put to death by Mirzafar's son Mehran. Sirajuddin Ullah ruling was end. Okay, he was being betrayed by the Mirzafar, who was the commander of the Nawab army. Now, result: the East India Company was granted the undisputed right to free trade in Bengal, Bihar, and Orissa. The company was given a zamindari of 24 Parganas. The Battle of Palasi made the English the virtual master of Bengal. It placed the vast wealth of Bengal in the hand of the British. These sources helped them to win battle in the Carnatic. Mirzafar was a puppet in the hand of the English. The victory in the Battle of Palasi transformed a mere trading company into a political power. It paved the way for the establishment of the British rule in India. Mirzafar was a weak and inefficient ruler. He had gifted a jagir to Cliff and the rich presents to the other in the company in return of the Nawabship. The treasury had become empty and Mirzafar was unable to meet the ever increasing demand of the company and its officials. So Mirzafar was deposed and his son-in-law Mir Qasim was put in throne. Mir Qasim handed over the zamindaris of Burdaban, Midnapur and Chittagong as a reward to the company. Now, Battle of Buxar. Mir Qasim was the last Nawab of Bengal. He endeavored to reassert royal authority. To consolidate his power, he introduced several reforms and organized a disciplined and well-occupied army trained by the Europeans. To improve his finance, he attempted to check the misuse of dastak. Dastak means or permit by the company servant who carried a duty-free private trade. This abuse ruined honest Indian traders through unfair competition and deprived the Nawab of large revenue. Mir Qasim took a drastic step to abolish all the duties on internal trade. Thus put English and Indian merchant on the same footing. This made the English furious. They could not accept the big loss and decided to overthrow him. In 1763 CE, war broke out between the Mir Qasim and the English. The Nawab, who was defeated, escaped to. Mir Qasim and the English. The Nawab, who was defeated, escaped to Awadh. Mir Jafar was reinstated on the throne. Mir Qasim formed an alliance with the Nawab of Awadh and Alam Shah. So Mirzafar was again. British wanted to overthrow the Mir Qasim, and behalf of the Mir Qasim, Mirzafar was again in the throne. Mir Qasim formed an alliance. Alliance is an agreement with the Nawab of Awadh and Shah Alam II, the Mughal Emperor. The combined army was decisively defeated at the Battle of Buxar in 1764 CE. Mir Qasim fled. Till here only. Thank you.